What's up, guys? Live here at A Cool Stuff Games Hollywood, and we got PPG-sponsored Yu-Gi-Oh! Player Eric Christensen back again, Dragon Ball Super Grind. This is his second or third top in a row. Huge locals. We had 50-plus players, and he was playing something interesting. No mecha. What were you playing?
Mass Saiyan.
Mass Saiyan. How did that go for you?
This deck is bonkers if you have a brain, so I think it's really good. In top 8, it was 7 mechas and then me. So.
Wow, that is insane. That goes to show how this meta is. And you went on top of a lot of mecha players. How many did you play, actually?
I played 3 in Swiss, 2 Mass Saiyan, and a Trunks.
Nice. All right, let's check out the deck.
Okay. All right, so I play red and black as the combination for the two. I've tried all the other colors. Obviously, yellow doesn't work with this. Blue is the other big color that's played in this. I don't like blue specifically just because in this deck you want to be aggro, and the blue cards that you play are kind of defensive, but I figured in this deck you really don't want to be aggro, or you don't want to be anything other than aggro, so I just cut all the other colors and stick to red because that's what red's the best at. For the red engine, I played 4 one-drop Champa and 4 double-strike Champa. It's the only target you really need. The best thing to do with this in your opening hand, if you have two of them, you keep both mana one and play the other. This is one of your best mana cards, and you only mana this either at the end of the game when you don't need double strike anymore, or if that's your only other choice for red. Obviously, this card's really good for critical. The other red cards you play are 4 Bodyguard Legic. Legic is insane against any deck that won the die roll, because he's getting out on the board for free. 1500, he's blocker against the GT deck, which is really good since they don't have a whole lot of pop in the deck. The next red is Kaba, Self-Awaken, he double strike at the end of the game. You don't really want to swing with him unless you're swinging to put them from 5 to 3 or at the end of the game after they've awakened, because you don't want to, everything in the beginning of the game, you want them to go to their grave, not their hand, so you want to swing with criticals like Leader or Mira first. So this guy's more of like a late game finisher, surprisingly, even though he's a one drop. The next for the black cards, I play 2 Dark Plot. A lot of people don't like this card, but once you hit turn 4, you can summon like 4 guys a turn, and that against apes, they don't have 4 blockers, they only have 2 to 3. So this card, coupled with the Trunks that it brings out, which is the ideal target for it, this guy is built in double strike. So having a double striker, then your Overrealm, and then one of your one drops and your leader, that's 4 swings that they can't stop all of them. So Dark Plot's really good for that. Next, of course, is the Super Combo. It's pretty self-explanatory. Every deck has to play Super Combo. The next one that a lot of people don't play are Supreme Kai of Time. This card's good because it searches any black battle card in the deck. Everything is under 5, so any card in your deck that searches that's black. You don't really play it against decks that are trying to kill you in turns 1 to 3, like against the Mecha Apes or GT deck. You can play it against the Veggie deck because they don't really do a whole lot on turn 2 when you ideally play it. You only play it if you're going first, because if you're going first, that means they only have 2 mana for their turn, and they can't KO you on turn 2 like that. So it's possible, but whatever, if they want to go neg to stop this one card, that's fine. Ideally with this, you banish either the Super Combo, depending on the matchup, or the Trunks, because if the Trunks, if this ends up dying, like a lot of times I'll banish the Trunks when playing against the Veggies with this, because if it dies, now the Trunks is set up there for the Dark Plot. So that's my mindset for this card. I really like it. I played a 4 before, but I realized it needed to go down, so I did cut that to 3. The next card that I really, really like is Relentless Destruction Mira. This guy got creased, I'm not cheating. This card's insane going first and second. One of the key elements that a lot of people don't do in this deck is they don't have 5 at the end of their turn 1 for their super combo. I like super comboing when I'm at 8 life. It makes me feel really secure. So this guy's really good. One for his effect, which is on summon, he pitches a card from your hand, which is really powerful when they're down on cards in hand, and you can control their hand a little bit more like that. It's really good when Frieza has like 3 to 4 left in hand, when they've done their big push, and they're saving stuff for, like, let's say Nimbus, and by summoning him, you play around Nimbus, it makes him get rid of like all their cards when they're trying not to do that. So he's really good for that. Next is the promo. This one self-awakens and it can target the blockers, which is a big thing. So he's just insane in general. He goes hand-to-hand with this guy, this guy's the Kale of the deck, but he can't hit blockers, which is a big problem against apes. That's why you need this. But they're just like your minion clear here. Next is the Trunks. I thought this card was super bad at the start of the set, and after playing with it so many times and milling so many super combos, this guy is insane. He just adds back a free guide to your hand, a free 10k boost that draws a card, or a Champa, and that's insane. And these are playable, like, you don't have to wait till you're at 4 life. This is always insane. I love this card so much. I don't play 4 just because I don't really want it, like, that bad. It's still a 2 mana cost, and I want to be able to play 1 drops in my beginning turns, so 3 is perfect for him, and you only need 1 banish for Dark Plot. The next time mained was Haruharu. This card is insane against the yellow deck, especially off Dark Plot, because it untaps all 4 of your energy for it. So it's a free summon off that. On turn 4, you can play a 1 drop, then play that, then you're back up to 4 and continue your turn on that way. It's insane. If it gets Bloodlusted, they just wasted a Bloodlust on a 1500. I don't really care about that. That's fine. Alright, the next card is Mira. Mira's obviously really good for this deck because you want it in your beginning sequence of cards, just for the critical factor along with the leader. Most of the time, until they get to 5, you really just want to crit their life. You don't want to do anything other than that. So Mira's obviously, of course, good for that. And then you search the Mira off Toa. I whiffed for the first time ever today with this card twice, and I was like, this is insane. My deck is 25 targets or so, like, for this. It's like flipping a coin 7 times and losing. So Toa's insane. I need 2 more holos because I'm amazing. I keep this in every opening hand, no matter how many I have. But yeah, that's the main deck.
Sweet. Side deck?
Side is 2 Goten. I like this against the Ape deck when they do the super combo out for the Vegeta that searches. You get that off the board so they can't go into the barrier. I like that. This is also for the Ape deck. I was playing 2 in the main along with 2 in the side before. I just realized that it's not that it's bad against the Apes, it's that I don't want to devote 2 red energy to it. And that's the problem with it. I also don't want to have to play at a disadvantage by having my hand size low. So that's why I cut him to just 2 in the side. It depends on the build of the mat. I don't really side him too much. I just couldn't really think of anything else to put in, so he was a safety net. Then the other 4th Haruharu for the matchups. Then the next that I really like, but it was awful in the main, was the Bardock engine. You play 3 of each. You play this one literally just so he can board wipe with his effect. Against the Ape deck, if they're tapped out and at 1 health, which usually doesn't happen, but it can happen when they're trying to push for game and you can defend it in your deck, this guy just wipes the board and then they have no chance of winning ever again after that point. So I board wipe 4 Apes off the board with this combo. You summon this and then drop that, wipes the board back to their hand, and they're warp, and they're done. Triple strike, 30,000 is insane. That's that. And then the MVP of the side deck is the hardest matchup, definitely is GT. Times Judgment. I milled 3 in my top 8, and I drew the other one, so I was a little sacky on that, but that's okay. But the main point of it is it's recurrence, so you only need to see 1, you just play 4, so make sure you get 1 to your hand. When GT is pushing you down and giving you 8 cards in 1 turn, you can't really combo out of it, you just have to take the hits. So giving a negate that's recurring just by dropping 2 of the cards they gave you is like basically saying, your guy's 60,000 and I'm gonna pay 1 mana and 2 5Ks to stop him. So that's what I like about Time Judgment. But that's it.
Awesome.
That's
all. Anything notable or any shoutouts you wanna give?
PPG, of course. But other than that, I pretty much worked on this on my own. A lot of people don't really want to play this deck, they just want to play Apes. So I understand.
And coming from a huge Yu-Gi-Oh background, second best player in the entire world, what do you like about this game, and how do you like it so far?
I really like the whole premise of this game. Kind of mixes all the best card games together. It's like Magic, Hearthstone, Yu-Gi-Oh, Pokemon all in one. I really like it. I love Dragon Ball Z, of course, too. So it's great. No real changes I'd make for the deck or for the game itself. Mecha Frieza, it's not that he's overpowered and unbeatable. It's just the fact that by playing him, you have to play like 1 of 3 leaders, which I don't personally like. So that'd be the only change. But in terms of cards, no cards need to be hit. There's no overpowered card in this game.
Well, you're doing an excellent job playing this game. Hope to see a lot more from you in the future. Thanks again for the deck profile.
No problem.
Peace.